my bond brush.
Okay, when did you do it? A lot of times it is used either at the beginning of Lent or at the beginning of Holy Week. It's long. It's a lot of prayers. It's rich. A lot of it is, you know, have mercy, you know, forgive our enemies, strengthen us, and just a lot of prayers. So it's a prayer that can be used, but it's usually used in a congregational setting, not as an individual. Okay, then you have the collects that do what?
Collect books.
Thank you. So you have traditional, which is what we use at 8 o'clock, okay, because 8 o'clock is always right one. And then we have the contemporary, which is what we use at 10:30. Proper liturgies for special days. We don't have any special days coming up until Ash Wednesday, which will be next year. Ash Wednesday introduces what season?
Lent.
Okay. Then you have baptism. We will be using the service of Holy Baptism this coming Sunday. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then you have the Holy Eucharist. Now, penitential order, rite one and rite two. I tend to use that at the first Sunday of Lent.
Where are you?
Use the penitential order. On page, rite two is 351, rite one is 319.
Okay, I never would have gotten that far.
Okay, then pastoral offices. Would someone read that list, please?
Confirmation, a form of commitment to Christian service, celebration and blessing of a marriage, the blessing of a civil marriage, an order for marriage, thanksgiving for the birth or adoption of a child, reconciliation of a penitent, ministration to the sick, ministration at the time of death, burial of the dead, rite one, burial of the dead, rite two, an order for burial.
Okay. Now, an order for marriage and an order for burial. Let's look at an order for marriage on page 435 of your prayer books, please.